In this video, we'll discuss about the theories of leadership. So in theories of leadership, we have three main theories. One is the trait approaches to leadership, then behavioral approaches to leadership, and contingency theory to leadership. The first one is the trait approaches of leadership. So what do you mean by trait? Trait is the quality. Okay, so according to this theory, leadership behavior is influenced by certain qualities of a person. Maybe we can call him as a leader. On the other wise, the leadership behavior is the sum of all the characters or the traits or the qualities that an individual has got. So trait theory suggests that the leader differs from followers with respect to a small number of key traits, and these traits remain unchanged across time. So the theory has also been called as great man theory because it is based on the set of traits which are common to great men. So now if you see some of the traits that which researchers have found out, or the number of qualities of leadership from their study. So the first one is the physical qualities. So physical qualities are sound health, vitality, appearance, and the physical and the nervous energy, forcefulness, physique, and enthusiasm. So all this comes under the physical qualities. When we discuss about the intellectual qualities, it tells about the intelligence and the judgment ability, the ability to teach, scientific approach, decisiveness, and the self-understanding. And the moral quality discusses about the integrity, the moral courage, the fair play, and the willpower, sense of purpose, and the objectivities. So these are all the important traits as such for an individual person. Then what about the social qualities? The social qualities, these are very important for the leaders because you're dealing with the people. So the ability to inspire, tact, percussiveness, self-confidence, empathy, initiative, knowledge of human nature and human relations attitude. So these are all very, very important to gain the confidence from the people. So in nutshell, we can put all these trait theories under the personality, social, physical, intellectual traits that differentiate leaders from non-leaders. So just put them all in nutshell, we can say the leader, based on the traits, we can call him a very ambitious, energetic, the desire to lead, honesty and integrity. He has got lots of self-confidence. He is intelligent and job-relevant knowledge that he has got. Next, we are moving on to the behavioral theory of leadership. So the behavioral theory of leadership talks about the leaders in terms of what he wants to do, right? The trait theory, we tells about the leader's quality on the basis of their characters, right? But here we'll talk about their behavior. So here we have a very famous major contribution. One is the Michigan studies, the other one is Ohio State University study, and the very famous managerial grit theory. And the third category of contingency theory I also included here. And the first one, we discuss about the Michigan leadership studies. So after studying the numerous industrial situations, the Michigan researchers identified two leadership traits. The one is the employee-centered leadership trait. Another one is the job-oriented or production-centered leadership style. So a supervisor is considered as an employee-centered if he allows the employees to handle most of the problems themselves and provide necessary assistance if there is any necessary. On the other hand, if you discuss about the production-centered supervisor, he is concerned more with the task than the people and who performs the task. So he regards the employees as an instrument only for getting the work done, rather than seeing him as the human beings with the needs and emotions. So Michigan researchers prescribed employee-centered style of leadership to increase the productivity, and production-centered approach is always frustrating to the employees, and that will affect the morale. right? That will lead to a very unsatisfactory performance of the job. So this is what about the styles of leadership that led that how it leads to increase in production and how you good you have to be for the employee centered work. The next one is the Ohio State studies. So this leadership style more portraying the Ohio State studies dimensions. So researchers of this university identified two leadership behavior. Right, one is consideration, another one is initiating structures. So what consideration refers to? It refers to the mutual trust, friendship and warmth between the leader and the group. And the initiating structure involves creating a work environment so that the work of the group is organized and coordinated in such a way that they know exactly what is to be done and how it is to be done. So here, if you see, there are again four quadrants. One is the task orientation. Another one is the human relation orientation, right? So here, if you see, there is a low human relations and orientation and a low task orientation. So this one is the first quadrant. And second quadrant is high task orientation with a low human relation orientation. And next one is high task orientation and a high human relation orientation. And here is the high human relations and low task orientation. So these four group is what they are discussing about. And the model is simple to understand and practice. So the logic behind the model appears quite reasonable and appealing. The concept is of consideration and initiation structure have led to a very high initiative appeal to the practicing managers. So they will see where they have to position themselves for getting the work done by the employees. And the next one is we are discussing about the managerial grit. So the managerial grid, you can talk about the concern for the people on one end and concern for production on the other end. So here a well-known approach to define a leadership in the managerial grid. So this was developed by Robert Blake and Jane Mountain. And the managerial grid is based on the massive practical research into a behavioral sciences in the industrial setting. And it is more of a theory in human behavior. So here the grid has two dimensions. One is the concern for people and another one is concern for production. Right. One by one we'll go. The first one when we discuss about the concern for people, it is not defined to a narrow consideration. And variety of concerns includes the degree of personal commitment towards goal achievement and maintaining the self-esteem of workers and placement of responsibility on the basis of the trust rather than obedience and provision of good working conditions and maintenance of satisfying interpersonal relations. If you discuss about the concern for production, it is limited. It is not limited to things only. So production must be assessed through a number of creative ideas and applied research turns into useful products, procedures, proposals, processes and quality of service. So it is more concerned towards the production. So here we built two axes. So one axis for the concern of people and another axis for the concern of the production. So here both the horizontal as well as vertical axis, here we treated from 1 to 9 scale. So on both the axis, we treated from 1 to 9 scale. And 1-1, we can say this 1-1 indicate the minimum standards indicate the minimum standards and coordinates. Here you talk about 1-1. 1-1 is the impoverished management. So the manager makes minimum effort to get work done. And it refers to minimal standards of performance and minimum worker dedication. So, and the next one, if you see the next coordinate, if we see it is 1 and 9, we call that as the country club. So here 1-9 is this one. So attention to the needs of people for satisfying relationship. So this is first one is 1-1 and second one, this one is we call impoverished management. And this one we call country club management because indicates personal and meaningful relationship with people and friendly atmosphere, high morale and loosely structured work design. And 9-1 is autocratic task where it is mostly task oriented and people, it is completely people welfare is foregone. And next, 5-5. 5-5 is middle of the road. And here, the satisfactory performance is achieved by equating the necessity of performance and reasonable morale. And 9-9, here's we call a team manager because it refers to an ultimate managerial efficiency and thoroughly dedicated to people as well as task oriented. So this is about the managerial grid, and the manager should see whether he is going to be in 1-1 coordinate or 1-9 or 9-1 or 5-5 or 9-9. So 9-9 is the best because the best teamwork is normally achieved in this grid. And second one, we are moving on to the fiddler's contingency model of leader situation. And this is called situational or contingency approach to a leadership. So the usefulness of traits and behavior is tested in a particular situation. So here, according to the situation theory, no leadership style is the best for all the time in all the situations. So situation helps a person to develop their leadership qualities and emerge as leaders. So the leader should adjust his style according to the nature of the task, the type of the followers and the environment to improve his leadership effectiveness. So if you see this here, we call a leader member relation, and then we have a task structure and we have a leader position power. The first one, if we discuss the leader member relations, so it examines the degree of trust that the group members place in the leader. So that indicates the degree to which the group member, such as the leader, and is willing to accept the leader's behavior. So if you talk about the employee relations, it is very good and more effective. The leader can be more effective if it trusted by the followers who are willing to accept his influence. So the very first four quadrants is very favorable. If here the relationship and confidence is not earned, then it becomes very poor. The next one is the task structure. So here it is focused upon the number of steps needed to complete the task. In other words, it measures the extent to which the task performed by the follower is routine or non-routine. And if the task is clearly defined and routine, group members can be more easily held responsible for performance. So here we say, we normally call yes refers to strong and W refers to weak, or it's a symbol that we normally use. And next one is position power. So it is determined by the degree to which the leader derives power from the position held by him in the organization. So it enables him to influence the behavior of others. So if the strong influence or a weak influence, and the leader with the considerable position power can easily obtain a better followers. So like how these are all used in the favorable and unfavorable conditions, fiddler's contingency theory discusses about that in situation analysis.